Hi guys, it's Manuel Monteiro. Today I'm with my friend Dwight, and today we are going to answer you a question that people have been asking me, especially students, English learners. They have come to me over these 5 years that I'm teaching English, and they come to me and say, Monteiro, what can I do to speak English? That's the question they have been asking me throughout these years. And for over 5 years, my answer would be, okay, if you want to speak English, you have to start English. But to my surprise, I have realized they have been studying English a lot, but still can't speak the language. So since last year, I have come with this great revelation, with a new answer. And then I used to tell them when they come to me with the same question, teacher, how can I speak English? And the answer is very simple. You have to speak. If you want to speak English, you have to speak English. Use the language. Find somebody to practice with. Go to your dorm, speak to your colleagues, speak to your mates. You have to use the language. So today I've got my friend Dwight, he's from Canada. He's gonna emphasize you about these answers. If you want to speak English, you have to speak. Mr. Dwight, please.
Well, I think one of the reasons why people don't speak English is because they're afraid of making mistakes.
It's true.
And the fact of the matter is, you're going to make mistakes.
Wow.
You can't avoid making mistakes when you're learning a language.
True.
And so you have to get over that fear. One of the things that I think would help for people getting over that fear is that nobody cares if you make mistakes. The only people who care about you making mistakes are English teachers. And how much time do you spend with your English teacher? And the English teacher's job is to help you get over those mistakes. And so how can they know if you have mistakes if you don't show that you have mistakes? But speaking English with an English speaker, they're not going to worry about your mistakes. They're more interested in your message. I always tell people that, for example, if you listen to the Pope, okay, Pope Francis, any of the popes,
from Catholic.
Or Ban Ki-moon, who was the Secretary General of the United States, or of the United Nations.
Yeah.
Horrible English. Their English was terrible, but nobody cared. Everybody was listening to their message, and they heard the message despite the poor English.
You see, and they're still in those big positions.
That's right.
With those poor English.
That's right.
You see?
The other thing is, I think that's important to note, is that the English no longer own the English language.
Mm-hmm.
English is a global language. That means we gave, in a sense, I don't mean we gave because we didn't own it, but people from different parts of the world speak English, but they speak English different from the way that I do. Their accent is different, some of their vocabulary is different, maybe even some of their structures, but it's legitimate English because that's their English. That's how they speak English in that country.
If they can understand each other, that's the point.
That's the point. So when I go to a country where the English isn't like mine, I have to learn that English.
Yeah.
I can't assume that people are going to say, oh, I need to speak English like you. It's like, no, I need to learn to speak English like you. So English is now, it's a free-for-all where you learn to speak and eventually English becomes your English. Your English is very different from mine, but it's your English. It's still English.
See?
Doesn't matter. So again, focusing on the message, worrying about getting the message across, because what happens is that when you focus on the message, the language comes, right? You will find the words, and if not, sorry for going back and forth.
It's okay.
But the speaker has a responsibility to make themselves understood.
Mm-hmm.
But equally, the listener has a responsibility to make sure that they understand. So it's their responsibility to ask questions to make sure that they've understood. So if a speaker is worried only about their speaking, well, they should know that the listener has a responsibility as well.
To understand.
Yeah, because it's
if
about...
If they don't understand, they're going to ask you repeat.
Yeah.
So thank you very much, Mr. Dwight. you see, my students and those who are watching this video, don't be afraid to speak English. Please, if you want to speak English, if you want to start speak English confidently, you have to use the language. You have to speak it. You have to find opportunity, create opportunity. Don't wait for opportunity. You create opportunity to use English. Okay, thank you for watching. Please don't forget to put a like on this video, to share with somebody that is learning English, for those who want to be encouraged and be more confident in speaking English. Okay, see you. Bye bye. God bless you all.